I'm Ben Leslie. My project's Finestra, and it's supposed to be a light, unobtrusive, dynamic window manager for X11. So, probably most of you noticed, but what exactly is a window manager? A window manager controls the placement of windows on your screen. It's the main interface in which you interact with the computer graphically. Now, it's not a desktop environment like GNOME or KDE. It's light compared to a desktop environment, and that it doesn't come with a lot of unnecessary baggage, like, gedit, extra mail utilities, whatever. So the point of a window manager is it's a more minimalistic approach to interact with the computer, more gives you somewhat more control, usually more configurable. And there's three main types of window managers. There's the tiling window manager, which looks like this. You can see it's very basic, very minimalistic. This is WM2, I believe. So usually people use tiling window managers like their terminals, like I do, but it gives you exactly, it fills up your entire screen with whatever you want. It doesn't waste screen space, it just gives you what you want, nothing more, nothing less. And it's in some ways more efficient to use. It's usually keyboard driven, you don't have to use a mouse a lot. The other version is it's a stacking window manager, which is like the one we use in Mac OS X. Most window managers are stacking. You got overlapping windows. It's not probably not as efficient as a tiling, that you can obscure other windows. You got to enable them. You got to maximize them, drag them, minimize them. And then there's the third type, which combines the two, tiling and stacking. So then you can stack windows in the background, maybe have floating tiles in the front foreground. And that's what I'm shooting for right now. Finestra is only tiling, and I'm actually using it right now. It's kind of basic, switch workspaces or whatever. So Finestra is, oh shit, I'm sorry.
You want to be market player,
yeah, the PDF is not skipping two pages at a time. So it's, of course, it's written, it's for X11, written in C, utilizes Xlib. It's primarily keyboard driven, it's light on system resources. It's supposed to be unobtrusive, intuitive. It's meant to keep your hands on the keyboard. You're not using the mouse a lot. So if you're using Vim, Emacs, whatever, terminal, it's probably more efficient compared to a stacking window manager. But I mean, like, you should always have options open. That's my opinion. I use multiple window managers. I use XFCE too, in addition to this. So that's probably the main point of Finestra, is to reduce that barrier between the user and his computer, to make it simpler to use for coders, system administrators. Now, if you're using the terminal most of the time, this is probably good for you. So right now, I mean, I'll do a little demonstration. You can open up multiple terminals, edit files here. Oh, I can't type with this. So let's say you want to edit some Linux source files. It's not opening, I don't know why. That's fine. Let's say you want to have like HDoc open while you're on RSSI. Not connecting to the internet right now. So you can also open multiple windows, shift them around a bit, move the barrier across, close windows. What else? In the future, I plan on having borders between the windows, so you can easily, these are little features right now. Borders so you can easily eliminate different windows. You can create workspaces on the fly, destroy them on the fly. So let's say you want to open up a workspace, you can hit a keybind, you type in the name, you hit enter, and we'll get another workspace. Hopefully in the future you'll have hierarchical workspaces. It's a little harder to implement right now. So you can like have a workspace that's all your work, all your source code, all your, edit. You pop out of that, go into your web browser, pop back into that, between the workspaces. Hopefully, a window stacking, so it's a dynamic window manager. Right now it's just a tiling window manager, I call it a dynamic window manager. Another thing is easy to edit configuration files. Now there's a lot of other tiling window managers, but I have, this is based on DWM somewhat.
Based on DWM?
DWM, yeah.
D is the box.
Yeah, D. Yeah, DWM, which is ironically what Windows is running Azure too. And you actually have to edit the source code for that if you want to configure it. And that's done on purpose because I don't like people, amateurs, using the program for some reason. And so I just want to have a normal text file that you can edit. Awesome, I believe, uses Lua. And I didn't feel like learning a programming language to configure my window manager. Did I say that? I don't want to learn a programming language to configure my window manager. And so another thing is to have integration with Clocky. Right now you can't see, I don't know what the time it is. You can add other features like how much battery have left, the wireless, wireless signal, whatever. And hopefully in the future I might transfer this to XCB so it's faster. I heard XCB is 200 times faster than XLib. Now this is so light on system resources. If you go back to, what is it? HTOP, it's barely using any system resources. It's not actually doing much, so it's currently blocking. But so use XCB so it's much faster. Maybe have a way to use Python. I think Python's a lot simpler than Lua, in my opinion, to interface with it so you can have even more custom ability. But those are way in the future. Possible. So I think that's it for now. Thanks to Arcos, Professor Morphy, and Sean Sullivan.
Now, how do you invoke the window manager from your terminal?
Oh, what's that?
How do you invoke the window manager?
Oh, I can show you. So this is the terminal. So you just run extend. When you start out, there's a thing called display manager, which does that. I mean, this is all configurable. I'm using Arch Linux.
Now it's sending your window manager.
Oh, sorry?
It is sending your window manager.
Yeah, this is it. I was using it all the time. Any other questions?
No? They may be specifically for ExoNet, which is what I use, but have you looked into using the Southwest tools or ExoBar and vMenu?
Oh, I use the vMenu.
Okay.
So
some of those could give you what you're looking for with the clock and stuff like that without too much extra work.
Yeah, it should be loading Chromium. That's a Facebook. But vMenu kind of integrates really nicely with this. So you just never use it before. Now there's a bug with Emacs and a Pigeon. It opens up an unnecessary window, and I don't know why. And it will crash the window manager. I have no idea about it. That's something I'm looking into. There's different, different interfaces with the window manager in the Windows. And I have that support with that. It's called EWMH or something like that. And I tell the clients tell the window manager what to do. So if you're closing a window, it tells the window manager to close that window, move it around maybe, change the side. Maybe it's a dialog instead of an actual window. So it's that support I have to add into. Yeah, that's a big document to read. So yeah, that's the finisher. Anything else?